Hi, I'm Dustin from Canomax USA, and today I'll be giving an overview of how to get started with your Canomax 6501 Series ClimoMaster Anemometer. Canomax's 6501 Series of ClimoMaster Hotwire Anemometers are available in two models, the 65010E, which is our base model, and the 6501CE, which provides additional options like air pressure measurement and analog output. Each model's base package comes with a sleek hard-carrying case and probe connector cable for connecting any of the eight different probes we offer. Six AA batteries are also included to power your device. Purchased separately, 6501 series probes come with an NIST traceable calibration certificate. The ClimoMaster anemometer does not measure airflow itself. It requires purchasing a Canomax 6501 series probe separately. Depending on your intended use of the Canomax ClimoMaster, you'll decide which of the available probes you'd like to include with your package. Probe model 65312G is a unidirectional rod-type probe capable of reading air velocity, temperature, and relative humidity within an air velocity range of 2 to 6,000 feet per minute. Probe model 65332G is an omnidirectional spherical-type probe capable of reading air velocity, temperature, and relative humidity within an air velocity range of 2 to 1,000 feet per minute. Probe model 65412G is a unidirectional rod-type probe capable of reading air velocity and temperature within an air velocity range of 2 to 6,000 feet per minute. Probe model 65422G is an omnidirectional needle-type probe capable of reading air velocity and temperature within an air velocity range of 2 to 6,000 feet per minute. Probe model 65432G is an omnidirectional spherical-type probe capable of reading at air velocity and temperature within an air velocity range of 2 to 1,000 feet per minute. Both probe models 65512G and 65522G are omnidirectional miniature type probes capable of reading air velocity within a range of 2 to 6,000 feet per minute. However, the 65512G model has a straight form factor and the 65522G model has a 90 degree bend for situations when your probe cable would otherwise get in the way of the probe sensor. And lastly, probe model 65612G is a unidirectional, rod-type probe capable of reading air velocity and temperature within an air velocity range of 2 to 9,840 feet per minute. Beyond the essential accessories you'll have ordered with your package, there are a number of other useful items that make using your ClimoMaster even simpler. Some of these items include an AC adapter for continuously powering your device, additional probe cables coming in lengths of 2 meters, 5 meters, 10 meters, and 20 meters. A flexible probe extension rod for reaching measuring points located around obstacles. A telescopic probe extension rod to give you an extra 34 inches of reach. A portable printer for printing your results on the go. And a hands-free carrying case allowing you to holster your device so you can focus on operating the probe. Each of these accessories and more can be found under the Accessories tab on the ClimoMaster 6501 Series product page at canomax-usa.com. The main industry applications that the ClimoMaster can be used for include HVAC, indoor farming, automotive, industrial applications, and universities. An example of testing for ventilation systems includes testing a clean room. There are a couple ways to set up a ventilation system for a clean room, but regardless of which system is used, the purpose is the same: to remove contaminants so the environment stays clean and controlled. To ensure your ventilation system is working properly, it's important to check the quality of airflow by taking measurements and comparing them to the expected performance of an optimal system. However, picking a device that can get the measurements you need will depend on the ventilation setup. For the purpose of this video, we'll look at the two most common ventilation setups and see how the Canomax ClimoMaster anemometer can be of use. The first is called a laminar flow system. In this setup, air flows through the clean room in one direction, either horizontally or top to bottom. To confirm that the system is working properly, check the airspeed at the supply vents as well as the distribution of air velocity throughout the room. You can also measure the volumetric flow at the supply vents or fan filters by using the following formula: Q equals V times A, where V is the average or center air velocity and A is the area of the vent or fan filter. And to measure the room's total volumetric flow, you perform the same measurements at each of the supply vents or fan filters and sum the results. Thankfully, modern anemometers like the Canomax ClimoMaster come with the functionality to do the calculating for you. When working with a laminar flow system, always check that the flow of the air throughout the room is in fact flowing in a laminar fashion and flows at the speed specified in the design specifications for the room. The second common type of ventilation system is non-laminar or turbulent airflow. In this case, the room is designed to dilute and remove contaminants based on a certain number of air exchange rates per hour. To check this type of system, you would measure the airflow at both the supply and the returns, and then calculate the number of air exchanges that occur per hour. After you've collected your data, it's time to compare your results with the design specifications for the room. Measuring airflow can be a tricky matter, especially when dealing with airflow that varies greatly across different parts of the system or room. This is why having multiple probes specialized for different conditions is crucial for making sure you get the best results on any job you take. Unidirectional probes like model 6531, 6541, and 6561 are ideal for conditions when air is moving in one direction. When using them, be sure to point the sensor in the correct direction by using the direction mark. In turbulent airflow conditions, where the air is moving in many directions, you will want an omnidirectional probe like model 6533, 6542, 6543, 6551, and 6552. Each of these probes have a horizontal 360-degree dynamic characteristic that measures air velocity all around it. Because the probe utilizes both an air velocity sensor and temperature compensation sensor to accurately measure air velocity, it's necessary that both sensors are evenly exposed to the airflow under the same temperature conditions. To operate the Canomax ClimoMaster, let's first go over the external controls, inputs, and outputs of your device. On top of the main body, you'll find three ports. The two ports grouped together are your negative and positive pressure ports. These should remain open and clear of any blockages whenever you decide to zero your device before measuring pressure. And the larger port is the probe socket, where you connect your cables and probes. The terminals and switches on the left side of the device are dedicated to data communications and power. Starting at the top, you have your analog output terminal for directly relaying measured data to connected analog devices. Below that is a serial communication terminal for interfacing with a PC via USB cable. The DC input terminal allows for continuous power when paired with the AC adapter. If you need to remain mobile, there's always the battery compartment on the back that can power the device via 6 AA batteries. When you're ready to power on or off the device, just flick the switch. If you don't have a probe connected to the device before powering up, you'll get an error message. So always make sure your probe is securely connected when you plan to use the device. On the front of your device, you'll see the LCD display and the keypad. The menu button cancels whatever action you're currently performing and brings you to the main menu. The start or hold button starts and stops the calculation and/or measurement. It also functions as a way to temporarily hold a current reading via a single press of the button, or each of the maximum values for the reading's parameters via pressing and holding the button when in normal mode. The navigation buttons can be used to scroll through any of the menus that pop up on screen. The mode button brings up your options for measurement modes, and when you want to make a selection, press the set button. Just to clean our slate before our first measurement, let's perform a zero adjustment procedure. Press the menu button to enter the main menu. Using the navigation buttons, scroll down to pressure 0 and press set. Use the navigation buttons again to highlight zero adjust. Select it by pressing set, then scroll until you see yes and press set to see the pressure return to 0.00 kPa. Scroll down to highlight save info and press set. And that's it. Now you're ready to measure pressure using connected tubing on either the positive or negative ports at the top of the device. Whether you're measuring pressure, humidity, air temperature, or air velocity, the duct shape and size settings must be entered beforehand. Up to 25 different duct types can be registered in this instrument, so don't worry about having to repeat this process more than you have to. Select the duct shape, then enter the width and height of the duct if you're registering a rectangular duct, or enter the diameter if it's circular. Before saving your info, make sure your units are set to what you want, and if so, you're good to go. When you first turn on the instrument, you'll find yourself in normal mode. In this mode, you cannot save any data, and the display is updated every 1 second. The navigation buttons allow you to select the time constant, 1, 5, or 10 seconds, for measuring in normal mode. This is useful for measuring turbulent airflow since it averages readings over a set time period. When you first turn on the instrument, the time constant is only effective for air velocity and airflow in normal mode. If you want to make it effective for air temperature, humidity, and pressure, you'll have to navigate to the main menu and to the utility section. In this section, you want to select TC THP Set and make sure it's turned on and that your changes are saved before exiting. While in normal mode, the measured item can be changed by pressing the mode button. The item changes with each press in the following sequence: pressure, flow rate, air velocity. When measuring flow rate, you can find the selected duct type in the lower left corner of the screen. If you need to change it, you can scroll to it using the navigation buttons and select it with Set. As mentioned before, while measuring in normal mode, pressing the start or hold button will hold the current reading. This is applicable in both the flow rate and pressure measurement screens as well. The hold indicator appears on the display to indicate that the reading shown is being held. To release the reading, you just press the button again. And to hold the maximum value while measuring in this mode, press and hold the start or hold button and the hold indicator will appear again. As long as you keep pressing down the button, you can hold the maximum value of each parameter: air velocity, air temperature, humidity, and pressure. When you release, the reading shown will be frozen. To release it, press it again. In calculation mode, the maximum, minimum, and mean of measured data is automatically calculated for you. To use this mode, navigate to its setup section via the main menu. On the following screen, you'll find all the adjustable parameters for this mode, but also an indication of the available memory for future measurements. The first parameter you can adjust is the mode. Average takes a measurement every second and then displays the average for the set sampling time. Instant takes a single measurement at the end of the sampling time. Next is the sampling time, which can be set to any number of seconds between 1 and 999. Third is number of samples. You can set this to a number between 1 and 9,999. Fourth is data storage, which lets you choose whether or not you want to save each calculation on the ClimoMaster's memory. To save all changes to these parameters, select Set to Start. This will bring you straight to the measuring screen. As long as the ready indicator is present, you're good to start measuring. To switch which items are displayed, press the Mode button. While measuring, you can press the Start or Hold button to stop. If you selected Yes for data storage, the measured data will be stored. Pressing the Menu button will also stop the measurement, but the data won't be saved. After the sampling is complete, the calculated results will be displayed, and you can cycle through each item's results using the navigation buttons. From here, you can either press Start or Hold to return to the calculation mode setup menu, or you can press Menu to return to the main menu. And so long as you previously selected Yes for data storage, you can jump straight to the main menu without losing any data. The Canomax ClimoMaster also features an accurate flow rate mode, which corresponds to the industry measurement standards, such as ASHRAE. This mode is useful for performing a measurement of the airflow of ductwork. From the main menu, select Flow Rate. Under this section, you have the option of choosing Single or Multi Flow Rate. Select Single. On the next menu, configure your setup similar to how you would in calculation mode. This time, though, you'll be configuring how many measuring points you want to include in your measurement and which numbered duct entry is being measured. Once you have everything set to your liking, select Set to Start to be brought to the Ready screen. If you need to change parameters before starting the measurement, you can use the navigation buttons and Set button to do so. The P stands for current number of points, the N stands for current number of samples, the D stands for the selected duct entry number, and the C or R stands for the duct shape and size. To stop the measurement, press Start or Hold. To continue measuring, press it again. And to complete the measurement, press Set. Then the results will be displayed. If point one is not completed, you won't see results displayed on the screen. Pressing Menu will complete the measurement without storing data. After completing the measurement of point one, the instrument will be in standby, ready to measure point two. The number of samples already taken will be displayed with the total number of samples at the top of the screen. After the measurements are complete, you can review each parameter using the navigation buttons. And as with the calculation mode, you can press Menu to return to the main menu, or press Start or Hold to return to the setup screen for flow rate mode. If you selected Yes for data storage during setup, your results will be stored in the device's memory. Multi-flow rate is very similar to the single flow rate mode, except it adds an additional parameter for the number of locations. This allows you to take several airflow measurements to get a total average. On the Ready screen, a new indicator, L, pops up, representing the number of locations for this measurement. The data that gets stored on the ClimoMaster during calculation mode and flow rate mode is dependent on the model of the probe you used for measuring. For example, if you used Pro Model 6541, it would be impossible for humidity data to be stored due to it lacking the functionality to sense humidity. If you want to recall stored data, all you have to do is navigate to the Data Output section in the main menu. By selecting Display, you'll be brought to the device's database where you can select pages displaying every bit of data from previous measurements. The mode, date taken, time taken, each individual parameter you configured for that test, and each sample and/or location's results. You can also filter through the different modes used by pressing the Mode button. To delete all data from the device, navigate to the section labeled Data Clear in the main menu. From here, you can define the range of pages you'd like deleted from the ClimoMaster's memory, or you can simply set All Clear to Yes and press Set to delete everything. To print out stored data, connect the printer cable to the serial communication terminal located on the side of the device. You can download the data stored in the ClimoMaster to your PC via the USB port and optional PC software. The 6501CE model offers 0-1 volt analog output. To output data via analog output, navigate to the Utilities section from the main menu and select Analog Output. Beyond configuring the analog output of your device, the Utilities section of the ClimoMaster offers multiple ways to customize your device. You have the option to adjust the internal clock of the device, select the default units used across your device, and the option to turn the LCD backlight on or off. If you have any other questions about testing with the Canomax ClimoMaster Anemometer 6501 series, feel free to visit our website at canomax-usa.com. Call toll-free at 800-247-8887 or email us at sales@canomax-usa.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos on the ultimate measurements.